What's good, YouTube? It's your boy Flyboy Quan, and I'm back again with another video, man. Yes, sir. Y'all already know the vibe, man. If this your first time on the channel, make sure you please hit that subscribe button, turn on post notifications, and like, because we are on the road to 4K. You know what I'm saying? We almost there, bro. Like I said, we so close to 4K. But anyway, man, y'all already seen the clips, so y'all know what I got for y'all today, man. I have the best jump shot in NBA 2K23. This is probably, in my opinion, this is facts. This jump shot is literally top three goated jump shots this year. Like, you know what I'm saying? I've been using this jump shot for a couple seasons. I started off the beginning of the year with this jump shot, but I had to alter it because it started becoming inconsistent. But I made one change, and it's been blickety blick ever since, man. So of course, y'all seen the clips. Y'all already know, man, you can shoot that thing from anywhere. Off the catch and shoot, green, money. Off the ISO, money. The fade is even clean, you know what I'm saying? It's just a really nice, fast, big green window jump shot, man. But anyway, we're gonna get straight into it, man. I ain't gonna take up too much of y'all time today, man. So let's get right into it. I'm gonna show y'all how to make it. You know what I'm saying? Let's see. So we can go to the animations. I'm gonna show y'all how to make the shot right now, man. So for the base, like I said, man, this jump shot goated, man. So you probably already familiar with this base because it's literally top two base on the game. LaMelo Ball base, baby. You know what I'm saying? Look what it does to my grade already. Just throwing the LaMelo base on. Like, even that shot right there. Like, I wouldn't use it, but don't look that bad. So we're going to go with, all right, LaMelo Ball base, man. Release one. Release one, Oscar Roberto Sin, you hear me? Listen, I know, rumor was they nerfed the Oscar. Oh, it ain't the same. Stop the cap, the Oscar ain't, you know what I'm saying? Whatever they did to him, it ain't affect me, because I've been blickety blick this whole time, shooting 60% from three, you know what I'm saying? Just easy money, man. And then release two, Oscar Robertson, man. Now, as you can see, you got A+, A+, A+ already. We ain't even touched the speed or nothing. Like, if you don't like fast shots, you can leave the speed right here at 3/4. You know what I'm saying? And it's still gonna be chicken. But what I do, I put it on 4/4 speed, which the A+ was already an A+, but it does get faster. A+ is just the highest shot you can get. You know what I'm saying? Speed wise, but great anyway. But the shot itself actually does get faster, and that right there is the jumper, everybody. Listen, man, this jump shot is so chicken, bro. Like I said, you seen the clips. You already seen what I was doing to people out there. And with the LaMelo base, you know it's easier to shoot from deep. So I be literally blicking from half court, bro. Sometimes I don't even got takeover and I'm just jacking from half court. Now, one thing I will say, the thing about this shot, like if you look at the height requirements, it says under 6'10". And as you can see, I'm using this on my 6'9". If you ain't seen my 6'9 video I just dropped, a lot of y'all was asking what jump shot I was using, so I dropped that for y'all. Go check that video out if you want to make this exact build. But so the height requirements, you have to be under 6'9". That means you 6'1 point guards, 5'11". Y'all can use this as well as long as you have an 85 jump shot, which is like the standard for this game. Like, if you don't at least have an 85, I mean, what are you even doing? That's like bare minimum for me. Like, if you want to be, you know, lights out, you need at least the 85. And then just know your shot. You can hit anywhere on the court. But like I said, you could be anywhere between, you know, 5'9". I think that's the shortest you can go. 5'9 or 5'10, whatever it is, all the way up to 6'9". So if you're over 6'10, unfortunately, you can't use this jump shot. But so now some of y'all may not like LaMelo base, or you've tried it and don't like it. That's fine. Listen. With this release one, release two Oscar, I'm going to recommend another one for y'all just because you stuck around. But LaMelo is by far my favorite. My second favorite would have to be, where is it? O'Shea Brissett. So as you can see, you still get all the A+. Look how fast that shot is. Look, he just flicks it off the wrist. You still get all of the A+ shot timing, the release, and the immunity. The impact don't matter. But this shot right here, you got to be in between 6'5 and 6'10. You can't get this on the smaller guard, so I would say use LaMelo. But look at the rating. You only need a 79 three ball to use this jump shot, which is what helps this jump shot. You know what I'm saying? You can have an 80 and use this jump shot. But this jump shot is clean. You're going to be able to hit from anywhere on the court. just like the LaMelo. And then I got one more for y'all. If you don't like that one, or if you're just familiar with Kuz, throw that Kuzma on. You know what I'm saying? You don't get the four-time shot. Well, the release height is in the A+, but you still got the A+ speed. And this shot right here is very, very chicken, too. I like this shot more for spot-ups. I feel like the Kuzma base is better for spot-ups, but you can't ISO with this exact jump shot. But listen, those three right there, you know what I'm saying? You got to be 6'5 to 6'9 for this one as well. Small guards can't get it. But that's why I say just use LaMelo, because LaMelo, everybody can use that jump shot as long as you got an 85. And to me, it is the best one. It feels the best. It's the fastest. It's got the cleanest release and all that, man. So that's it for the video, man. If y'all want the release cue, it's going to be right at the top. Like, you really got to just lock in with this shot, man. I'm telling you, once you lock in with this shot, it's going to change your life, bro. I had somebody that I play with every day. They was 50 ball. Like, you could lead them open, bro, and they would shoot 30%, 40%. But listen, ever since I gave him my shot, he finally asked me. I don't gatekeep, but you got to ask. I ain't going to just get to you. You know what I'm saying? But he finally asked me for the shot. I gave it to him. And listen, when I say you cannot lead this dude open, you cannot lead this dude open. Like, it's literally going to turn you into a sniper, because the jump shot is so easy to time, and it's got a huge green window, and it's super fast. So a lot of the times, like, when people get contests on me, if it's not at least like 13%, I'm gonna hit it. Like, I'm gonna green it. Like, it don't matter, bro. Like, you gotta be hands up, like, and jumping at me when I'm shooting. If not, I'm gonna green you, man. But like I said, the release cue is right at the top. Soon as the ball is at its highest peak, you want to release it right before he flicks his wrist. Also, if you want to know my shot timing that I use, I do shoot on late. So there you have it. I shoot on late, man. Late is the best shot timing. I've been using late since like day one. I never changed it. Everybody said go early, very early. Late always worked for me, so I never changed it. And I just been, you know what I'm saying, like I said, shooting 60% all year, man. But that's it for the video, man. I appreciate y'all, man. If you enjoyed the video, make sure you hit the like button. Try this jump shot out, man. Let me know if the jump shot is chicken or not. Comment down below. Let everybody know so they know to go make this jump shot right now, man. Like I said, we on the road to 4K, so make sure y'all subscribe. I got more videos on the way. And we're going to turn up all the way to 2K24 drop. And then when that drop, we going crazy, man. Let's get it.